Well, good afternoon, everyone. Happy holidays. Here we are on the 26th of December and coming to you live. This is Araya on Raw. We are here in the For the Love of Dragons group, which I am so excited every week to talk to you guys and to answer your questions and be that guide for you to find the next tool that you need to get you on a deeper journey with the dragons. To really explore that connection, because for some of you, it's new. You've gone to a healer or a massage therapist or a reader of some kind, and they've told you you have a dragon in your field, or maybe you had a meditation and all of a sudden you started feeling that and you found your way to this group, and there's a reason for that. Your guides are always bringing you where you need to be to get to your next step. So I hope that you find some tools here. That's what I'm here for. So if you have questions on the journey, please message me, please email me, make comments in the video. I do catch all of them. Hello, Liana. Hello, Candace. Because that's my purpose here, is to be that guide to help people open up to that dragon connection and what that means for them. And for some of you, it means a great deal more because you are dragon hearts or dragon keepers and you're discovering that and what that means. So hello, hello to everyone. I hope you had a wonderful Christmas yesterday for those that celebrate it, or Hanukkah getting underway and Kwanzaa getting underway today. Hello, Lanny. And I'm excited today because we have some readings and I find it so interesting. You know, when we trust the universe and the divine perfect timing and alignment of things, I really thought I was going to come on last week and do some readings. And because of the holiday, everybody was sort of in their own places doing their own thing, and not everybody was on the live like normal. Hello, Diane up in Canada. So I put it out there that the first three that responded back would end up getting them today. So what's beautiful in alignment with that today is this reading is taking you into this next phase, this new cycle. So if you're not aware, today, the 26th of December, 2019, is the last new moon of this year. It's also the last solar eclipse of this year, which we've had quite a few very powerful solar eclipses. And hello, Carla. It's taking us into our next phase. So you know that whole new moon energy, it's starting something new. It's diving into an expansion, an opening. As is the solar eclipse, it's heralding something that's expanding us forward into this gate of 2020. And I know many of us have had sort of 2020 out in front of us as this point, like a turning point of some kind, sort of a like a almost a global, there's something big going to happen in 2020. And I do still feel that. I feel like we're really entering that phase, and having read recently about the beautiful stuff happening down in Uluru with the indigenous elders and how they've shut down the site. It's a very sacred energetic site, and I found it interesting that that happened right after what we did in Kailash. Hello, Jackie. Because that was a big turning point energetically of what things have been waiting to align with the grids around the planet, with some bigger pieces falling into place, and that they turned around and said, you know, the Dreamtime story was interrupted. It's time to complete it. And so nobody else is going to go on that mountain anymore. And they're starting sacred ceremony. And there's a sacred ceremony happening January 12th that we can all align to. My whole body's tingling on talking about this. So that is a huge confirmation for me. It always is, of this is truth being spoken. This is a bigger message out there to be paying attention to. That if you mark on your calendar January 12th, just to align your hearts to the indigenous peoples that are working around Uluru, around what used to be known as Ayers Rock, if you haven't known it by that term, that the Dreamtime is going to be completed. And this is an activation of a gateway that goes out to the cosmic sun and the greater sun that aligns the planet to allow it to move into a golden age. And it's heralding that breakthrough into the fifth dimensional plane for the entire earth plane, so that it's all these points that we've been feeling coming available, coming into our experience of touching these pockets of fifth dimensional experience or expanding ourselves into it, even temporarily or momentarily, that now it's starting to be available on a much bigger regular basis. That once that ceremony is complete and that ceremony is aligned, they're doing it on a day that's very auspicious with a conjunct of four planets. So I believe it's Saturn, Mercury, Jupiter, and the Sun. I might be misspoken on those four, but I know I've got at least three of them right. But that's a very unusual alignment. And so aligning to that, there's a lot of power in that. There's some big gateways and openings happening. So pay attention on January 12th, whether you feel like aligning into meditation or not. And if you do align into meditation, just as you always do with these larger activations that you can't be on site for, that you tune into your internal body, you tune into your heart space, into your high heart if it's activated and you're working within it, and expand from there with your energy body, sending your connection out directly to Uluru and the group. And you'll probably feel that energy building and moving. You'll find yourself drawn to it. And just add in your good intention and your good blessings for that to move forward, because the more gathering of individuals from around the planet that are sending energy into that gate, the stronger and faster that it activates, which is the truth of any activation. So knowing and seeing the perfection of that alignment into the work that I'll be doing over the next year, and aligning some pieces that will follow in footstep with that energetically. So excited to see. I've actually been called to Uluru in 2020. I knew that was coming, also to Mount Fuji. That's going to be coming up sometime in 2020. So seeing where the dragons play into this, and how that fits in with the Aboriginals and activating the song lines is doing, and maybe being the other end of that gate, because I feel like it's almost a year from now, at the end of 2020, that I'll be called over there to do the dragon activations. So just find it very interesting that this is the day, the auspicious day, that as we move into this new cycle, moving forward to 2020, we have a new moon and a solar eclipse, and you can probably feel it. For me, I was sitting with this energy today, feeling about what I was going to talk about with you guys, and choosing, like, when I go into my closet, I sit and tune into what color is drawing me, what texture, what feel, before I grab clothes. And interestingly, the most luxurious sort of regal feeling thing that I have, it's this shirt from India. It's this wonderful velvet thing, but when I wear it, I feel regal. I feel like that royalty aspect, that it brings out that higher light in me, choosing even called to gemstones and jewels and things that felt more aligned with that energy. And for me, it's all the sapphire, it's all the blue. And what that tells me is that aquamarine stone, that is my stone of connection with Tana, my greater water dragon self, is part of that, that carries that regal energy for me with her. And so tune into that today and just feel with this energy, being called even just to put that on and have that energy surrounding me physically, because the energy is already hitting all of my energy bodies, my spiritual body, my mental, my emotional, my dimensional bodies. All of this package is feeling that energy because of this new moon and solar eclipse alignment. And for me, in speaking with that, this regal aspect is all of us actually feeling that call into the regalness of our higher self, because the truth of our divine being, the truth of our highest self aspect, whether we are dragon or star being or whatever family we hail from, whatever realm our souls incarnate first and foremost within, that your truest self is in a very regal state. It's aligned with that divine aspect of Mother, Father, God. It's in truth, in alignment with its divine masculine and feminine. So this to me is stating very clearly that the energy of this alignment today for us moving forward into 2020 is about that true call to coming home. And there's my full spinal whoozing that says, yes, indeed, 2020 is about coming home. And that's actually bringing up a big wave of emotion. I'm going to tune in and see if that's really just mine. I feel like it's all those on the call are going to be watching the replay that are going to feel that and know that that call to self, that call to aligning with your truest self and really sorting out how to get there, how to get aligned with your truest self and be in sync with what you're here to do, who you be, how do you align to that, and getting that call. That's what 2020 is about, that energy of bringing the divine to earth, our divine selves to earth, aligned with us here in this physical form. And it'll be the first time really on the planet, other than Yeshua, who showed as an example after his physical death, how he aligned and brought his light body into being here on the planet where others could interact with it. And now the task is for us to learn how to do that while still in physical body, that we don't have to release the body through physical death, but allow our light body to come in. And what does that look like to walk in that mantle and be aligned? Hello, Susan. Yes, please. And Inger. It is definitely about that alignment and bringing our full self, our divine self, our regal self, because our light self, and my whole body's still zinging on this, you guys. This is exciting that this is what we're talking about today. Pay attention to how this will affect you in 2020. This is what this year is about, bringing that divine self in and being able to walk in your regal self, because that's what's going to allow you to live in that fifth dimensional space rather than being lost in the chaos of the 3D realm. And you know what I mean? It does feel sometimes like we're separating into more and more of chaotic 3D, almost like a black and white curtain being drawn of, whoa, 3D reality is so heavy, so dense, and there are billions that are going to be stuck in that or lost in that because they're not yet ready to amplify into that higher octave of themselves, into that higher space. And yet those of us that are, we're holding that space so that they can bridge that and that we can create that for the whole planet. But it is going to feel like a very divisive line starting to happen where you feel the difference of what your comfort zone is, and that you just, it's very, very hard anymore to walk in the 3D, almost like stickiness or like mud sucking you down in of what typical 3D life is about here on the planet for many people, being lost in the commercialism and the egotism and the narcissism and everything that is part of the social technology world that, you know, a lot of people hide behind their identities. And we'll, you know, we're here on Facebook, this is how we meet, and we're able to come in a circle that allows us to be in truth and radiate and really be who we be. But there's a lot about social media that really is about a mask and about putting yourself forward in a light that is not your truth, that is something that makes it easier for you to be accepted or liked or embraced by a lot of groups. And a lot of people feed actually energetically off of how many likes they get or how many different pieces of response or mail or messaging they get back and how many friends they have, because it's feeding that pocket of shadow within them that has not embraced and brought themselves home. So let's send a big heartfelt blast out to all those beings that are in that space and not realizing even that they're almost dependent on the energy. And this is where the addiction of Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and all these things comes in, of not even realizing that they can't live without it. They can't go through a day without it. I've seen these reality shows of people that had to give away their phone for a week and they were like transformed and realized like how dependent they were, and yet they went back to it the day after, because it's feeding that hole within self that is not being fed through other real means, and being able to accept and embrace the hard shadows and the pain and the grief that is stuck in the soul that needs to be released through deep shadow work. And that's what the dragons have a gift of bringing us through that transformative shadow work so quickly and directly and with so much more ease. So I encourage you, if you're watching this and haven't got the book yet, The Dragon Within is that guidebook that will take you through so many layers of release, because the dragons are ready to work with you, and it walks you step by step with them how to do that. And that might be the greatest gift to 2020 for you, to just get on your path, to start moving that direction. So I hope that any listening that aren't there yet will feel that call to dive in. All right, that said, I know we're excited to do some dragon readings today. I haven't done these in a while, so I'm excited. I love these mini live readings. And I had three people, it was to be the first three that responded by comments last week. And so I've got a list here. I've got Tammy Poulin, I've got Candace Tkachuk, and I've got Francesca Snick. And I'm going to do them one at a time. I'm going to dive in and give just whatever is coming through for them from the dragons, whether it's a team of dragons or individual dragon. I'm just going to tune into the dragons that are working with them and either what they're there for or how they can connect more deeply. So let's go into this for Tammy Poulin, starting there. Whew. As I drop into a reading space, I'm just going to allow Tammy's dragon or dragons to step forward. So it's interesting, I feel the energy coming through Tammy as a very almost like lace-like quality to the energy. It's a light blue, very delicate, very, like I said, like that feeling of lace, just intricate, detailed, almost like lattice work. And this is how the dragon is presenting, actually, as if this is what it's made of. It's this beautiful, intricate, almost like, if you imagine like a loofah one of those sponges that has so much space in between each of the cells or the structure of it, that there's a lot of space in between it. And so feeling this structure coming up, and this is just how the dragon is presenting its energy to me today so that I can actually get more information than just a straight visual of it. But there's definitely this light blue quality. It feels like a baby blue quality, which is interesting. So there's an aspect of childlike fragility. Energy is also very soft. And above the light blue, it's a white framework. So I'm really picking up, Tammy, that you have, it's almost like that white framework is presenting or showing a host of angelic beings. Your angelic guides are standing around your dragon to lend support, but they're allowing the dragon to step forward right now in prominence. So really feeling for you, if you've had a lot of work with the angelic realms or feel really called to them, that they are your host support, and yet they're wanting you to focus on the dragon piece right now, and that this one is stepping forward. And this soft, delicate energy, it's like being held. This dragon is gonna work very gently with you, because there's some aspects, and this is where the childlike frequency is coming in. There's aspects from your childhood that need to be dealt with in a very delicate light framework. And it's very soft, it's very, like I said, spacious between the netting or the whole, the loofah-like structure. And yet this light blue is also crystalline. So there's a high octave. It's like a perfect balance. It's like you're being taken into this very delicate, fragile pieces from childhood that have to be wrapped up. They have to be completed. And you're being held in this just beautiful space with the angelic realms. And this very etheric crystalline quality to the light blue color as well. Meaning that if you can finish and clear, ooh, my whole body's starting to tingle on this part. This is exciting. If you can finish and allow yourself to drop into this space and go through this really fragile, delicate stuff from childhood that needs to be completed, you're going to be able to move into an octave. It's like, it's almost like having two sides of a sphere and allowing it to flip-flop as it completes. And so having that come full circle around, that as this completes, it allows an opening into a higher crystalline frequency for you to step into, which will come forward with this dragon is definitely from the crystalline realm. She was revealing a lot of crystalline geometry, and this is part of her delicate lace-like structure. It's actually geometric within it. So pay attention to geometries that start showing themselves to you. And to be able to call this dragon in specifically, let me pick up a name for you, Tammy. Wow, I'm just hearing a really high-pitched tone, so I'm just sending a call out from my heart if there's an actual sound structure within that. So I'm being shown to actually just give you that tone. Tell me if you can repeat or reproduce a tone similar to that, even if it's internally in your mind, if you don't feel comfortable using your vocal cords, that's actually the stream of energy that this dragon will flow in on. I do feel a sound signature within that, but she's wanting to reveal it directly to you. And it is a she. It's definitely a female. So, wow. Hello, Linnell. Good to see you, Arno. Hopefully that gives you some insight there moving into 2020, Tammy. It's always beautiful for me to connect with these different dragons that are working with people. It's always so beautiful to see and meet them. And I always get exposed to different families of dragons as well. This very crystalline lace-like structure when it's sort of a new representation for me. I remember being exposed to a flame dragon for the first time last year because someone came and had a reading and was like, wow. There's actually flame dragons in the realms, and I'd forgotten about them, and it's how it wakes up within me. It's so beautiful. So let's move on to Candace. Candace Tkachuk, I know you're online watching, so I hope you are paying attention now. I'm going to shift the reading space, pull myself into a different sphere, and allow Candace and her dragon team to be present. So interesting, very immediate shift. There's a very deep, very powerful yellow. Let me pick up on the tone of the yellow. So it's like a golden sun yellow, not quite an orange, but a really deep, deep golden yellow. I'm hearing similar to wheat fields, so at harvest time. So that's the color of like the golden sun combined with the wheat fields, or the sun shining on the wheat fields at harvest time is the frequency coming with this dragon. It feels very stable. It feels very, not dense, but rock-like, like just solid. It's very solid. And it's interesting because it's in such contrast to the one that I was just working with or sitting with. And so Candace, this dragon is bringing it, it's the color of the sun, it's an awakening, and it's a pull forward to you into the light of the sun, into your, you have a golden framework is what's coming through. And that this being is emanating through the sun lineage of dragons. And they're bringing in the reference of the harvest at the wheat fields at harvest time, because this is like moving into a harvest time for you, that there's things that you've been working on really in a dedicated way, that it's like harvest time. Like now it's time to really reap, that you're moving into a cycle. And this is why she's rock solid. She's holding ground for you. She's, and again, it's a female. She's, it's almost like being that strength of groundedness that you need for the reaping and the harvesting of everything you've been doing, that's going to put you into such an expansive state, like the expansion of the sun expanding out and beginning to glow and be brilliant in a light that it puts out. And in order to have you expand into that, you have to have a really grounded framework. So within your golden framework, she is the one holding. It's almost like being the center candle in a centerpiece. She is going to drop down into your framework and be the solid piece that connects you to I don't want to say to density or to even being grounded in the earth framework, but it's like holding you in such a grounded place that it allows you to explore and expand up here into these spaces that are your harvest, that are the product of all of the work you've been putting in. And so she's just stepped forward. I feel like she's been in the background, almost like overseeing all this stuff that you've been doing. And there's been other dragons stepping forward with her. It's interesting that this this golden guy is falling forward on me as I talk about that. Almost as if he's jumping out saying, hey, that's part of my family. So she's been in the background as you've been working with other I want to say modus operandi is the words that are coming, but you've been doing a lot of different types of work to get yourself to where you're at. And now, and she's been in the background sort of watching and holding, waiting. And now she's like, all right, now you get to harvest and expand forth. Let me see if I can get a signature name for, so you can call her in or feel her presence more directly, especially when you want to do direct work and go into a meditative space. I feel like you're going to feel her step in from behind you, almost like sitting in your root chakra, as if she's weighting you down. I can feel it very heavy in my body, almost like a golden, if you imagine how like the gold of the sun, if it comes through and densifies into 3D and it becomes liquid gold, and it sits into like a, almost like a statue density, and sitting in your root chakra. I keep hearing Soranum, who is one of the solar dragons that's mentioned in the book. It is his family line, and I feel her. Wow, Sorana. The I feel like she's the female aspect of Sarunum. If when the dragons actually come down into 3D or lower realities, they come into their masculine and feminine parts more easily rather than being their androgynous normal selves to work with. And I feel like this, she's showing me the split, and so there's definitely like a power aspect with that, because he holds a real strong power lineage. So Sarana, you might feel Sarunum actually around the sphere, holding like a masculine balance, because you're gonna feel very balanced in this space. But she is the one inside the circle working with you, Sarana. Oof. So Candace, I hope that gives you something. I felt that energy through my root chakra recently. Yeah, she began working with you about not quite 2 weeks ago. I'm picking up like 11, 12 days ago, started coming in. So beautiful. Enjoy working with her and give us a report. Like, send me an email or a post when you get some information from her or feel that connection happen. I would love to get a follow-up and know how that works for you in connecting more directly with her. All right, so finally we have Francisca Snook, who found the replay on YouTube and responded with a comment very quickly to get in on the reading. So, okay, switching reading spheres. Francisca, you're coming in immediately with a lavender to deep purple. I'm picking up a full array of like a lilac, very light purple, into the lavender. The lavender is the base core energy that's running, but it does expand out into a deeper purple. I'm gonna let this dragon step forward more clearly. I can see the belly is the very light lilac. The body framework is the lavender. The wings are the deep, deep purple, and really nice deep markings along the brows, the horns, down the neck, the edges of the wingtips, the ridges along the tail. There's an energy of serenity with this dragon. Let me just see if she's, if, is it a she? This one is definitely fully balanced male-female, coming in fully androgynous. You will feel the different masculine or feminine aspects working with you at any given time. You'll know which side is presenting and the things that you're working on, but there's an aspect of serenity. There's also a yellowish-orange dragon, and you feel the much smaller one. This one is in the forefront. This other smaller one is behind you and to your left, as if helping you. So this yellowish orange is coming through from air dragon lineage, trying to help you gain higher perspectives, and sort of sitting on your left shoulder. Feels like your left side, your feminine side, is sort of skewed in its perspectives based on some feminine pattern wounded in your family lineage. So she is sitting there holding a space for you to have true reflection and not be reliant or dependent, or falling into the patterns or perceptions that you have on a regular basis from that female lineage, from your mom, your grandmothers, their grandmothers and mothers, that there's been a sort of skewed perspective towards the world, towards actually even, and so this is coming in the serenity aspect that you're working on, of the feminine's right to have serenity, almost as if they were like overachievers, overworkers, or didn't feel like the female was allowed to rest, that the female was allowed to be in a serene space and take care of self and go into those deep spaces of inner reflection to grow and expand, that they're just, you know, really about daily earth responsibility, task, the woman's job, woman's work, like so much importance placed on that. So this perspective is, you'll feel this energy almost like a whirlwind or a tornado sometimes off your left shoulder that's trying to spin out and remove as you sit with things or get insight from this other dragon that's out in front of you. And that's why they're working, the purple one in front of you is working in both the masculine and feminine aspect to bring you into a space of serenity and allowing serenity in both your masculine and feminine aspects. And because it's hard for you to do that specifically in the feminine, this air dragon back here is creating not a turbulence, but a vortex or a almost like pulling a centrifuge type energy behind you to pull. It's almost like watching wisps of energy be pulled out of your mindset or your psyche that are ingrained patterns of perception and belief towards the feminine. That it's like you have this very frontier avant-garde like desire in understanding the feminine, in being that feminine, in being in that divine role and in a balanced place as the feminine. And it's been hard for you to really move into it and embrace it because of these little voices from the past that just keep trying to tug you into like your alignment with responsibility and the women's work in the world. And so they're being pulled. It's like this vortex behind you, pulling them out of the psyche to allow you to move forward into this beautiful, serene energy that this dragon is holding for you. Let me see if I can get a take on a name or mantra that will help you call this dragon forward when you're ready to do some work or just to connect heart to heart as you sing her mantra from your heart space. And I do feel this. I feel like this is going to be a real vocal one for you to sound. I'm feeling a run of blue energy coming up, which is showing your throat chakra actually expanding this out. So it will be good for you to chant this mantra to bring it. It's almost like it invites, as you chant it out, it's inviting this purple energy down into your communication spaces. And so that's where a lot of these feminine perception issues are about, the communication that will bring serenity. So interesting that framework. So it's Jir Nyai Ashna, and it comes with that sing-song melody to put it out, because that, even repeating that, and you have to repeat it at least three times to begin the flow of energy that is going both outward from you but inviting and cycling back in from her, it will create a space of serenity for you that's going to just drop you into some insights. I feel like the combination of this one stepping in front of you, and this is a family member, this beautiful lavender dragon is definitely a family relation from the dragon realms coming in for you, and the air dragon is assisting to create what you need behind. So there's a lot about currents for you, of following and allowing the flow of currents. So allow the energetic flow, Francesca, to be what you follow when you're sitting and working with her. There's a lot of this almost figure eight movement or a circling movement of energy moving out from you and in from her, and out from you and in from her, and allowing that, because she's bringing in a cycle of energy that is closer to home for you, which has been hampered so far in you connecting to and finding that serene space within to really expand into you, because of all this like psychic chaos from the feminine side of your family. And it's not that they're overbearing or trying to do it. It's just the family that you chose to step into for other reasons that will reveal. But now it's time to release that and break free from that, especially as we enter this. And this whole, wow, this reading for you on the new moon is really important to dive into this as you move into 2020. So between now and even January 12th, there's a whole bunch going to come up for you. And my whole spine is tingling on this again. So I hope you're really able to take some time in the next 2 to 2.5 weeks to be with her and feel that shift, because that is going to set up the dynamic for the rest of the year for you for 2020. That's the serene space you need to go in so that you can take the next steps after that in what unfolds. And you're going to have a lot more insight come in because all these perceptive filters will be pulled out. So I hope that's helpful, Francesca. And this is super fun. I love doing these. I will do them again. I'm not sure when, but I will definitely put a list out. So pay attention and watch for that. If you're wanting those readings, I saw a lot of comments that, oh, I'd love a reading, or this and that. And I know I apologize for those in the UK who are watching the replay, or all the European countries, even New Zealand, Australia, that this is the time frame I do it at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard, which most of you guys are in bed already, which is makes it so you can never catch those and probably get in on time. So I will do some lives spontaneously at earlier hours and make that possible for you sometime in January. All right. Also sometime in January coming up, I've slated the first book club of 2020. That's going to be a powerhouse group. Seeing the energy that's coming up, especially after January 12th and that four planet conjunct, I've decided to start at January 30th. We're going to go through March 5th. It's going to be on Thursdays. And I have a list of people that let me know since the last one, that they are very interested and want a spot. So I've got a short list to email to give them the first spot opportunity. So if you want to be on that list when I send the information out officially in the beginning of January, please email, text, or message me so that I can actually get you on that short list, because I only have 10 spaces each time and it does always fill up. So really excited about that, because it is super fun. I love the book club. It is a transformative 6 weeks that sort of blows everybody away with the meditations each week and how much energy gets flowing and how many breakthroughs actually happen from a book club, right? It's so much more than a book club. So hello, Denise and Misty. Thanks for coming on live, everybody. I know there's not a lot of openings in the next couple of weeks, but if you're wanting to schedule a discovery call to see what and how we could do to work together, what would benefit you, or set up a full 20-minute dragon reading for yourself, or a full 75-minute session to kick you off for the new year. My booking calendar is under the Book Now button on either dragonwithin.com or invokehealing.com is where you'll find it. And go ahead and grab any spots that are free, because that's going to get you off to an amazing start for 2020. So Carla, hello. You are welcome. What a pleasure. I love coming and doing this, and we've got some power energies today. So allow yourself to drop into those, allow yourself to connect to them, and put your heart's desire out for what you want for 2020. What do you want for your own journey? Do you want to expand in the most brilliant way? Do you want to come home to you? Allow your guides to line it up and bring you the steps forward that will make not only transformation and shift happen for you, but in an expedient way. And that's what the dragons are best at. They are so efficient and they work quickly, and they don't want to waste any time. They will not shortcut and leave anything out, but they will not waste any time, and they will radically push you forward, which is what's needed right now moving into 2020. So always love being with you guys. I'll look forward to next week, and I'll see. I might be coming live from Lake Tahoe next week, and it might be a snowy wonderland. So we'll see what we're going to discuss next week on that. If you have questions or things that you want me to talk about or explain or help you understand, please put them either in the comments or send me an email, araya@dragonwithin.com, so that I can talk about that next week. That could be you getting your answer right there. All right, Happy New Year to everybody. We will see you in 2020. Bye.